ratio of how many support trees to one target fruit tree in a guild? And how does that ratio play off in different climates? Well, there's not an exact answer to this, but it will depend a little bit on what you have available. I always reckon you can't have too much because the support trees are all sacrificial. You can always cut them for mulch. You can turn them into pollards and coppices, or you can just generally keep cutting them so they die out and their roots stay in the ground. I like to plant 8 to 9 support species. That's not just trees. 8 to 9 support species to every fruit tree, minimum. So one larger legume, one medium legume tree, one small legume tree, one little tiny bush, 4 or 5 small plants, 1 or 2 groundcovers, some herbaceous support that I can cut for mulch, all of them sacrificial in the end, more or less. Maybe one might go on indefinitely with the tree as a functioning pollard. Maybe one is in the canopy. Maybe. It doesn't really matter. The idea is they are support. So they are supporting the fruit tree through to climax in a natural fashion of succession. So you're cutting, you're mulching, you're letting shade in, you're shading out, you're shading over, you're manipulating the support. They are supporting. So the more support you have, the better it is. You can't oversupply the support and get into trouble because you can always cut it for mulch. It's never really taking. If it is, you've got the wrong tree in support, haven't you? Support trees are trees that are supportive of the growth of the trees that you want to end up in the system. So they're not allelopathic. They're not necessarily even neutral, although there might be some neutral ones in there. But they're definitely not negative. They're positive in some way. And if you oversupply with positive, then you can always cycle them faster. Now, often it's just that you just don't have enough trees. You can always have more support. Now, there's almost not a top number in there. It's like, well, I run out of space to put anything. Well, that's probably your top number, isn't it? There's definitely a bottom edge to this where you just haven't got enough support to get it to function like a natural ecosystem where these processes are always in play when they're coming through succession and sequences of pioneerism. So if you don't have enough, the consequence is plants you don't want getting in the situation, plants that don't help, more work, more maintenance, more water, more fertilizer, generally more inputs. So don't think too much about how many, but can I get enough? Can I get them all in different layers? So I've got some ground cover, I've got some tubers, maybe I've got some clumpers, I've got some short-term legumes, medium-term legumes, long-term legumes. If you oversupply it, you can always cut them out. And Bill was the same. I remember Bill having like 12 large legume trees in 1 acre. And you think, wow, that's way too much. And also have like 30 or 40 fruit trees. So you can always sacrifice those because you're speeding up successional processes. This is where we can play the part of speeding up the systems of nature.